Anybody who's been hiking in the desert or mountain biking is having a good time and then will find themselves thinking, well, what if I see a snake? What do I do? Well, thanks to guys like Jason, knowledge and education makes it better for all of us. Jason, it's so good to see you again. How's everything?
Good. How are you, John?
Great, great. Hey, how would you describe what it is you do? Without the fancy title, what is it you do?
So basically, I'm a reptile biologist for Nevada Department of Wildlife. And so what I do is I go around the entire state of Nevada, and I look for reptiles. I often try to estimate their populations or understand more about their movements or their behaviors, their general ecology, so like what eats them, what they eat, so we can better improve the way we manage those snakes or lizards or even turtles.
And why do we care?
That's a good question. So they're kind of the canary in the coal mine. With climate and habitats changing, reptiles are a great indicator species to those changes, and they respond pretty quickly. So populations, when they decline, usually signal something's going on in an ecosystem.
How did you get started in this line of work? I mean, as a kid, were you digging under rocks looking for stuff?
Yeah, and as a kid, I had a lot of different salamanders and snakes and lizards and frogs, and so it just kind of grew into a professional thing.
That's interesting. A lot of times when that happens, the people look like the animals, but you don't look like, you don't look like a snake at all. You look like a good guy. All right, so what have you got today for us?
So we have a number of different species. We'll first show you the gopher snake. This is the most likely thing you'll probably encounter here snake-wise.
Do you ever name them?
In Sloan Canyon. Yeah, this guy is named Slinky.
Slinky?
Yeah.
All right.
And so gopher snakes, as you can tell, get really big. This one's over 4 feet long.
Beautiful.
They're usually completely harmless. Obviously, if you harass anything, any person even, you're likely to get bit. So,
how do you identify the gopher snake?
So pretty easy. So on the back tail there, you can tell it's not a rattlesnake because you have this really pointed tip,
yep.
Right? And that's really important for indicating that it's not venomous, at least here in Nevada. All of our deadly venomous snakes have rattles.
Oh, interesting. So if I see a snake and it doesn't have a rattle, chances are, most likely, it's not venomous.
In Nevada, yes, you're correct.
Interesting. Yep. Okay.
The other way you tell is the pattern. Now, you're going to see some rattlesnakes that have a similar-looking pattern, but these guys also don't have a flattened head. Their head is relatively uniform with their neck.
Yeah.
However, these guys can do something cool where they flatten that head like that, and they make it a little more triangular. But a really accented triangular head is also indicative of being a venomous snake.
Now, is it a gopher snake because that's what they eat?
Yeah, they'll eat a lot of small mammals. They're even known to eat other snakes like rattlesnakes. But for the most part, these guys are considered a mammal eater.
A lot of tongue flicking in and out. What's he doing?
So it's really neat. Snakes have this forked tongue, which allows them to essentially catch chemicals in the air and take that, and they have this thing called a Jacob's organ in their head, which essentially their tongue goes right to their brain, and they can actually take those molecules and make sense of them. So not only can they seek prey that way, but also they're obviously, he's checking you out and kind of getting a better understanding of who you are. So these guys are actually a king snake, which means they're the king of all snakes.
Wow.
Meaning they can eat other snakes and readily do. Turns out a study that was done a couple years ago found, I think it was like 15% of their diet may consist of rattlesnake.
How old is this one and how big do they get?
So this one's pretty young. This is about a little over a year old. And they'll get about as big as our friend the gopher snake, which is a little over 4 feet.
So some of these snakes can have different personalities. Some can be a little more aggressive than others. Mm-hmm. Is that true?
Yeah, definitely. Wow. Mm-hmm. Yeah, some snakes, obviously, you know, you hear tales of different rattlesnakes being more aggressive than others. But it all depends on the individual. And obviously, you know, if you're dealing with a snake population that gets harassed often, they may be a little more vigilant in terms of rattling or being defensive and displaying that kind of really aggressive posture. Whereas other snakes may be a little more docile and allow you to walk right past them without rattling. So
what
this
do you got
is
here?
A sidewinder, and this is likely one of the more common residents, at least from a rattlesnake perspective, that you'll see here in Sloan Canyon. This is a really big sidewinder. They are generally really small. And, you know, compared to a gopher snake or a king snake, you know, this is a really small species. But you'll notice it has a lot of segments on that tail.
Yeah. You mean the rattle?
Yep. And that indicates that it's obviously a few years old. You can't tell the real age of a rattlesnake based on the rattles, but you can certainly tell when they're really young because they'll have a button, which is essentially like a kind of a pre-rattle.
What is his behavior when it comes to seasons and temperature?
So sidewinders are actually really neat. They're one of the only rattlesnake species I can think of that seem to operate when it's a lot colder than other rattlesnake species. So these guys do a good job of ambushing their prey and just kind of sitting in the sand. So they're able to absorb a lot of that sunlight by sitting under shrubs.
Active at night or in the day?
You know, they'll sit and forage during the day, and at night you commonly see them crossing roads or moving across the landscape.
He is really camouflaged, isn't he?
He is, especially in this environment. If we put him down, he's almost non-existent.
He's non-existent. And who is his predator? In other words, who's looking for a meal out of him?
So a lot of ravens, coyotes, badgers, fox, a lot of those are gonna attack this. And as I previously noted, king snakes are common predators for rattlesnakes.
What else you got?
So we have a Mojave rattlesnake, and this also can occur here in Sloan Canyon. And this one, talking about misconceptions, this one's probably one that has maybe some of the most misconceptions. You'll notice some folks call it locally here a Mojave green, and that's due to this green coloration. But they're not always green, they're kind of a brownish color. So Mojave green is kind of a local term, but they're known as the Mojave rattlesnake.
What time of day are you most likely to see one?
So really in the mornings and evenings, you're most likely to see a rattlesnake. Now, depending on the season, if it's early in the spring, these guys are pretty active during the day, and they can also be active obviously in the fall when it's warmer during the day. However, in the summer, you're more likely to see them at night.
Is this the average size for a Mojave green?
This is a pretty decent size for a Mojave rattlesnake, yep.
Now, any of the snakes that you've shown me today, are any of them just in Nevada, or are they all in the Southwest?
So they're all pretty much in the Southwest of the snakes I've shown you today. Yep.
I'm stunned because when you first see it, it's a little startling, but then to watch you work with it, I can almost see what it's thinking. It's just curious about what we're doing right now, isn't it?
Right, yeah. And the fact that, I can manipulate them and move them around. We don't like pet these snakes. They have fairly large size enclosures that they live in, but in terms of human interactions, they don't get a lot. And so, this is kind of really what a lot of snakes will do. They just kind of try to seek a hiding spot because obviously they don't really want to interact with.
Wow. Okay. You can let him go back. I've had my fun. I have to tell you how impressed I am with their relationship with you and everything that you're doing, because you're educating people about these animals, and that could literally save lives. And so all the work that you're doing, it's huge. It really, and I just want to say thanks.
Thanks, John.
Good seeing you, man.
Good seeing you.
Stay healthy.
You too.